The fiber Kevlar is stronger than steel, and it's revolutionized everything from body armor for the military and police to sports equipment. Its inventor is the subject of tonight's Hidden Histories for Women's History Month. Here's Allie Rogan.
Skis, brake pads, racing sails, space suits.
I think this is just a fantastic looking suit.
And perhaps most famously, the bulletproof vest. These products and many others are made with Kevlar, a strong, lightweight fiber invented by researcher Stephanie Kwolek in 1965. It all began when DuPont Chemicals asked researchers to make a fiber that could withstand extreme conditions.
The solution was very, very fluid. I mean, it was almost like had the consistency of water.
Synthetic fibers start in liquid form and are spun into a strand.
So when I asked the technologist to help me with the spinning, he refused because he said, this will never spin. It's too fluid. It probably has particulate matter in it because it's cloudy and so forth.
But Kwolek was convinced it would work and persuaded him to give it a try.
Well, the results came back and they were sort of unbelievable.
The fiber was lightweight, heat resistant, and 5 times stronger than steel.
There, of course, was immediate excitement because everybody realized the potential of this discovery.
But Kwolek did not set out to become an inventor. Growing up outside Pittsburgh, she considered fashion, inspired by her mother, who sewed. Later, as a bright student, she thought about teaching. By the time she started college in the midst of World War II, she was determined to go to medical school. She chose to major in chemistry at Carnegie Tech, now called Carnegie Mellon University. But when she graduated, her plans changed again.
Since I could not afford to go to medical school at that time, I had to go out and seek employment.
She got several job offers, but one stood out for its interesting work and for paying men and women the same starting wage.
And so I took the job with the DuPont company. The only problem was that I became so enamored of the work that I totally lost interest in medical school.
When she started, DuPont's research laboratory was in the middle of a race to discover fibers that would revolutionize not just fashion, but war and space travel.
Miss Gloria Glamour thrills to the ultimate in hosiery.
Just a few years earlier, the company had created the first synthetic fiber, nylon.
No baggy knees or deforming wrinkles during the life of a nylon stocking.
That fiber's success and wartime rationing of natural materials like silk and rubber set off an intense competition between companies like DuPont and Monsanto.
There was tremendous interest in new fibers and new ways to make fibers.
Over the next 2 decades, the group created the methods and techniques that would be used to make spandex.
That's one small step for man.
New polyester and acrylic fabrics.
These curtains are made of Dacron polyester fiber.
And the flame-resistant Nomex. But there was another, stiffer, stronger fiber waiting to be discovered, Kevlar. In 1964, Kwolek's research group was tasked with finding a fiber to make durable, lightweight tires to improve fuel efficiency in cars.
It got to be a race, but it was a very, very secretive race, so that very few people outside of our laboratory knew, you know, what was going on. But it still was a lot of fun, particularly if you won.
And they did. Kwolek cracked the problem in 1965, discovering a version of the polymer that could be spun up into a fiber. Fiber B, as it was known internally, became Kevlar, the basis for a whole family of products. Kwolek spent the rest of her career at DuPont. She mentored other women in her field and worked to introduce young people to science, writing letters and giving lectures.
I really did not think of the bulletproof vest. We had Dr. Joe Rivers, who at that time was already looking for fibers to use in making bulletproof vests. And I remember the very first time that I spun the 14B that he came over and he said, if you can possibly spare a tiny bit of that fiber, I would like to test it and see if it'll be useful in a bulletproof vest.
She was named on a total of 28 patents and won several awards for her work, including the National Medal of Technology. Kwolek was inducted into the National Inventors Hall of Fame in 1995. At the time, she was only the fourth female inductee. But to Kwolek, her crowning achievement was making Kevlar possible.
I was fortunate enough to do something that would be of benefit to mankind. It's been an extremely satisfying discovery. I don't think there's anything like saving someone's life to bring you satisfaction and happiness.
Kwolek died in 2014 at the age of 90, but her greatest invention is still saving lives today. For PBS News Weekend, I'm Allie Rogan.